the sages tell us that each of us should feel that the world was created for me. Now that sounds incredibly egomaniacal. Why should we feel that way? And the answer is so that we'll take responsibility, so that you'll realize you were put here in the world to do something. You have a mission, and it's not to lie on the couch. So perhaps, though, nowadays, in the situation where we find ourselves still in the middle of the ongoing pandemic, there's a corollary to this. Maybe each of us should feel that God pressed reset on the world, introduced COVID, changed everything about the way we interact because of me, or because of you. Now you'll say, because of me? What in the world did I do that was so terrible? I get it, I'm not perfect, but press reset on the world, the pandemic, because of me? Maybe yes. And the more you ask why, the more that may upset God. Like the stereotypical husband who comes home and his wife is very upset. He says, what's wrong? And she won't tell him. And he says, why won't you tell me? And she won't tell him. And the more he asks, the more upset she gets until he realizes that he's obviously the problem. He did something wrong. And then it hits him. Oh no, he forgot their anniversary or her birthday. So of course, the more he was asking, the more upset she was getting, because he should have been able to figure it out. And we should be able to figure out what we're doing wrong. Maybe as we get ready for Yom Kippur, it's time to take a good, long, honest look in the mirror. Not to look for gray hairs or for pimples, but to make an honest accounting of where we're standing spiritually. To go through and chart the things that we're not doing that we know we should be doing, or the things we are doing that we know we should not be doing. Every one of us struggles in certain areas of our spirituality. Some of us have difficulty with honesty in business or in interpersonal relationships. Some of us find it difficult to properly honor our parents. Some of us have trouble keeping the Sabbath or keeping it properly. Some have difficulty with the kosher laws. Some of us find it very tough to restrain what comes out of our mouths. Vulgarities, falsehoods, gossip, and insults. Others struggle with giving charity or giving enough charity. Some of us find it difficult to set aside time or enough time to study or to pray. But rest assured, no matter what area it is in which you find that you're struggling or which you find difficult, there are others who have the same problem. Unless you're a serial murderer, many people out there struggle with your issue. And so maybe this Yom Kippur, it's time to lawyer up, to bring a class action before God. The sages explain that the best way to ensure that your prayers will be answered is to pray for someone else who has the same issue, the same struggle, the same difficulty. And so maybe we can appeal to God this Yom Kippur, not just on behalf of ourselves with our individual issue, but on behalf of everyone who has that issue, asking God to please grant us a reprieve. We feel very bad about our failings from the last year. We deeply regret them. And we, not just me, we, all of us struggling with that issue, want another chance. Get rid of the pandemic. Give us a year of health and let us work on that area that when we're honest, we know and admit needs work. And hopefully, this year, each one of us will not only resolve and aim to be better, but will succeed.